Hello and welcome to Casino del ASMR. I'm your dealer, Joy Scola, and today I have with me Miss Karina Rachel.
Hello. I'm just here to learn a little bit about playing poker. I'm so excited.
This is Karina's first time playing poker, so I'm going to walk her through all the steps. Just follow along and learn. First, we start by giving you your chips.
Thank you.
These are worth $1. And the reds are worth $5. And the pinks are worth $25. There is no minimum bet, so you may place your bet.
Well, I'm feeling pretty lucky, but I'm also not feeling very optimistic about my poker skills. I think I'll just do $1.25 because it matches my dress.
Place right there for me. Perfect. You'll find that most beginners have wonderful beginner's luck. Let's see if the same holds true for Karina. So first, I start by shuffling the cards. Now, blackjack usually consists of multiple decks, but for learning's sake, I'll stick with one.
That sounds like it's going to make my odds of winning a lot better.
Well, if you know how to count cards, this will surely be to your advantage.
Well, I do know how to count.
So you want to make sure that the cards are nice and shuffled. Oh, the waitress should be by soon with another drink.
I hope she'll hear my plea.
Perhaps some more hors d'oeuvres. Especially when using a new deck, you want to make sure that it's well and mixed. I'm just using a simple one over the other shuffle method. But if you go to other casinos, you may find that they use the bridge shuffle effect. Once I have thoroughly shuffled my cards, I will let Karina cut the deck. So that means she will grab a certain amount from the stack, set it to the side, and I will take the stack that was existing underneath and place it on top. And now we're ready to begin.
You know, Joy, I understand that we're learning about poker, but I have to say, I love your dress.
Oh my, thank you so much. I just got it from this fabulous new dress site.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Well, that's quite a coincidence because my dress also comes from a fabulous new online dress shop.
Oh my goodness, I was going to say that I love that purple lace design.
And I match the chips.
You do. Lady Luck sure has it tonight.
She certainly does.
Alright, first card to come out. So I deal the first card to the customer and keep my first card face down on the table.
Now that seems unfair, doesn't it?
It does a little bit, but it's to add to the surprise.
Oh, I understand now.
Now, it doesn't matter how many people there are at the table. Each person is personally playing against the dealer, not against each other. And each person is dealt two cards, one after the other, in order. So now, the cards are laid out. As you can see, she has a 6 and a 7, giving her
13.
That's right, she can't count. And I have a king with a card hidden. Now the object of the game is to get as close to 21 without going over as you can. You want to get closer to 21 than I do. Now, you always want to assume that the card that is face down is a 10. Might not be the case, but to be safe, that's what we want to have in our heads here. So with 13 and I have 20, you may want to hit, but she's more than welcome to stay.
So if I go over, I immediately lose the game?
Yes, so that's considered a bust, and I will take your cards and your chips.
Well, that wouldn't be very nice of you, would it?
I know. It's the object of the game.
Well, at least you look exceptionally cute.
And so do you. So I might go a little easy on you.
Well, let's see. So what do I do if I think I'd like another card?
All you have to do is tap the table twice for another card. And that is a hit. Now, if she were to stay, she would merely wave the table. Now we have
15.
Perfect.
Still not 21.
Still not 21.
And quite a bit less than the 20, I'm assuming, that you have.
Precisely. And another card comes up.
Oh dear.
And there is your bust. Because now we have 10, 12, 18, 25. Four over what we were hoping for. And I take the chip, as well as her cards. Now it's up to me if I would like to display the cards that I have.
How did you know? Are you doing magic tricks too?
Oh, you know it.
She's really good at this, apparently. I'll have to remember that.
Playing with a professional. Now there's one thing you must know, is that us dealers are trained to always win. We have set guidelines that we must obey and cannot break.
So you can't break the rules, can you?
No, ma'am. How's that vodka on the rocks treating you?
It's delightful.
Cut the deck, please. Thank you. So since that was our practice run, I'll go ahead and give you back your first chip.
Oh, that's so sweet of you,
Jess. Yes, I told you. Lady luck. All right. And coming out with the first card. Another 7 again. And mine stays face down. Nine. I've seen people come back from a lot worse.
It's not looking so great for me.
And a jack. So here we have 9 and an assumed 20. Would you like to hit? Or stay.
Well, yes, please. Okay.
19. Perfect.
I'll stay.
Now, I'm going to display my cards. 16. I as the dealer, have to keep playing until I hit 17. So I must draw one more card. And I busted, which means that she automatically wins her chip.
Yay!
Congratulations.
I have to say, I'm liking poker more and more.
I'm so happy to hear that.
Do you know any cool card tricks or anything?
I'm practicing a simple card illusion. Let me see if it'll work for us tonight. First, I'm going to spread the cards on the table. Take the top card, slide it under the beginning. And move it back and forth.
Wow. That looks pretty neat.
Thank you. So as I said before, still learning, but practice always makes perfect.
Well, I think it was an astonishing card trick, say so myself.
Appreciate that. Maybe that's just the booze talking. So go ahead and place your bet for me, ma'am. All right, and here we have 30. All right, looking good. First card off the deck.
An 8 versus a 10.
Quite the hand you have there.
So I'll stay.
Perfect. An 18, I must stay, and therefore she automatically wins, as she is closer to 21 than I am. And I will match your bet as your winnings.
Well, thank you. Okay, well, feeling lucky.
All right.
I'll just leave 50 on the table.
Perfect. And the card comes out of the deck. So now we have 13 and an assumed 13. I'd like another card. 17.
I'll stay at 17.
So now I'll flip bid and card, and there I only have 6, and must play till 17. 17. So when we end up with the same amount as the dealer, that is called a push, which means you do not win, but you also do not lose.
Now that sounds like a situation I could get used to.
I'll take the winning, thank you.
Well, that's certainly nice, but it's also nice to not have any loser at all.
That's true. All right, so the bet stays.
That really doesn't keep a casino running, does it?
No, it doesn't. We want your money. Would you like to hold your bet?
Well, I am a Texas girl, after all.
There you have it.
So
100 on the table.
Yes.
Perfect. Now, in most casinos, after the bets are placed, you will see the dealer sweep the table with his or her hand indicating all bets are on the table, no more touching. If you try to reach your hands in after, you'll get in trouble.
Okay, thank you for telling me. My luck of three. And a ten.
19.
So you think they named that store Forever 21 after Blackjack?
Huh, perhaps. Maybe the dealer. Maybe the owner always got 21.
Maybe so.
Alright, so 13. And I suppose in 19, what would you like to do? She would like to hit, which means she will accept another card. And there you have
18. Well, it's awfully likely that I'll bust if I take another card. I think I'll stay.
So the motion?
Oh, sorry, I confused them.
That's quite all right. This is while we're learning. And I will flip. I have a 12, 18, I must play until I hit 17. And there I have 20. So I win. Karina loses. I'll take the chips.
I shouldn't have bet so much. Can we retake?
That is the name of the game, and that is why it is gambling, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, man.
That's okay. Who's to say you won't win it back?
Well, now I don't even have...
If you wish, I can just show you some other fun things that we have.
I would love that.
Great. I think we've had enough of the blackjack for today.
Had enough losing.
And here I have some really fun see-through cards. I'm going to take a gander at those.
Those are fancy cards.
Yes, they're rather fun. A switch up from our usual.
You know, I've never seen clear cards before in my whole life.
They're pretty nifty.
I have a question.
Yes.
Why do some cards have a bullet hole through them?
That is when the casino is done with a deck, since it can only be played a few hands, and when they dispose of them to keep players from being able to tuck a few up their sleeve, they punch a hole through them.
I always wondered that. I thought no. That's a way to ruin a deck of cards, isn't it?
That's a way to ruin it. But you can always just use them to play with still. Let's see if I can try that same trick with plastic. Nope.
They're not quite as flexible.
They're not quite the same. A bit heavier than your typical paper cardboard deck.
Oh, here's this one back for you.
Thank you very much. We also have, for your pleasure, this little fun contraption.
Oh my, is it a necklace?
It's much cooler than that.
Wow. Now that is something I could spend all day playing with.
Me too. You can even wear it on your wrist. Careful you don't catch your hair now.
Well, that is awfully neat.
Yeah.
Can I find one of those in the Casino del ASMR?
Yes, you actually may find those in our gift shop.
Oh, that would be delightful.
Now I also have with me...
We could play Yahtzee.
Yes, we could. Would you like to teach me how? Perhaps another video.
I would have to brush up on my Yahtzee.
As would I.
Another thing that matches my new dress.
It was meant to be.
It certainly was.
Well, thank you so much for watching, and I hope this gave you some insight as to how to play blackjack.
I definitely look forward to playing with you again.
As do I.
Welcome to the ASMR Salon and Spa. I'm Karina, and my friend Joy is here to help me to make a back-tickling video just